Hello and welcome to Emma Reads Reddit. Today I'm reading from r/todayIfuckedup. First, let's play r/drunkorakid. Inspired by How I Met Your Mother, I give you a real life scenario and you guess whether it was a drunk or a kid. This one was posted by the Saber Maniac. Running like a madman, forgot to turn, ran directly into a brick wall. Head split open, blood everywhere. But what do we think? Was this a drunk or a kid? Find out at the end of the video. Now back to r/todayIfuckedup, where Gay for Aliens 1701 posted this. Today I fucked up in a sex shop with my dad. This happened many years ago, but it is one of my favourite stories. When I was 17, I went to Ireland with my parents, who were there over my birthday, and I decided I wanted to get my nose pierced to celebrate. My mum and dad asked the hotel concierge where we could get it done. They recommended a place and off we went. As soon as we walked in the door, we realised it was a sex shop. We were surrounded by hardcore fetish gear, toys and porno videos, but a worker greeted us brightly and confirmed that they indeed did piercings in the back. My parents were permissive and liberal when I was a kid, so they just kind of shrugged, giggled with me and let the guy lead us through to the back. A heavily tattooed, outrageously attractive woman pierced my nose, and although I did not know yet I was a lesbian, I was certainly interested in the way she apologised for the pain by saying, "Sorry, sugar," in her lovely Irish accent. Piercing complete and a bit woozy, I walked back into the sex shop to find my parents, and spotted my dad standing in front of a wall of dildos. "Checking out the dildos," I joked. But, to my dismay, the man who turned to face me was not, in fact, my father. This poor, random Irish guy took a look at me and said uncomfortably, "I'm just looking around." Keep in mind that I was 17. I'm 4'11" and looked about 12. So from this man's perspective, an actual child had just interrupted his sex toy browsing to question him about his behaviour. Mortified, I threw up my hands and said what came to mind first. The most situationally absurd sentence of my life. "Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I thought you were my father." As the man's face contorted in horror, the implication of what I just said hit me and I fled. I found my parents and shooed them out of the store. I told them what had just happened and they laughed all the way back to the hotel. Too long, didn't read. My parents accidentally took me to a sex shop to get my nose pierced. I jokingly asked a man I thought was my father about browsing dildos. The man was not my father, but I apologised by implying that my father and I were shopping for sex toys together. In the comments, "Too shifty for you," says, "Man browsing the dildo section." I guess my fetishes aren't that outrageous after all. Oh. This next fuck up was posted by Steve88. "Today I fucked up by slapping my mate on the ass in the middle of a busy supermarket. This happened about an hour ago and I still can't get the look of this poor guy's face out of my head. I, a 32 male, had been out running some errands this morning and decided to grab a few things from my local well-known supermarket. A lot of the time I go in there to grab a couple of things, I end up spending 40 minutes in the store because one of my good friends, Jim, no real name, works there. We end up chatting about all sorts and getting a catch up as we don't tend to see each other much in the real world." Oh, so you're the guy in the employee blocking the aisles for everybody else. "I've known Jim, male, 20s, for about 4 years. We both played on the same American football team for a few seasons. And anybody who knows what that setting is like will know that a slap on the ass can mean many things and happens way too often. I'm walking down one of the aisles and standing at a trolley is Jim with his back to me. Easily recognisable, I can't go wrong. Longish ginger hair, not too tall and built like a linebacker. Without a second thought and absolutely no hesitation, I walk up, slap his ass and say, "Hey buddy." Time slows down. Everything goes into slow motion. My heart stops. Jim turns around with a confused, astonished yet shocked look on his face. Jim aged by about 20 years since I saw him. Because a mid-40s man turned around, looked me up and down and asked, what just happened?" I froze. "What the fuck do you even say to that?" "Well, you're not Jim," came out, and then I walked away. You know, that weird quick bike walk you do that's fast but isn't quite running. Customers looking at me. Watch me walk away whilst turning bright red. I hadn't picked anything up at this point, so I walked straight out of that store. I messaged Jim and asked him if he was working today because I thought I saw him but didn't have time to stop. Apparently, I slapped the ass of a guy called Mark, a new guy who's being dubbed Jim's dad at work because of the resemblance. I didn't tell Jim what happened, but he's bound to find out next time he's at work. If you're going to slap and ask of a friend, 100% make sure it's your friend. I'm at home, door locked, and wanting the world to swallow me up. Too long, didn't read. Slap my mate on the ass as a greeting in a supermarket. Wasn't him. Accidentally slapped someone else's ass. In the comments, Lao Tao Dao says, I had a similar experience. Friend worked at a large toy store. I was there one day, and as I walk round an aisle, I see said friend on his knees stacking the bottom shelf with his back to me. So I immediately run to jump on his back. As I was mid-leap, he turned his head and virtually shat himself as he saw what was a random bloke about to jump on him. I startled and managed to twist out of the way. The guy saw the funny side as I explained my fuck-up. Pope Francis down in the comments had this to contribute. I was at a Blockbuster, a place that used to rent movies out on physical media before the internet was fast enough for streaming media, with my then girlfriend, now Facebook friend, and came up behind her, embraced her, and asked if she'd seen anything good. It wasn't my girlfriend. Luckily, the lady believed my shock, apologies, and my girlfriend came up right around then, and the how I got confused was obvious. This comment just says, I just witnessed someone explaining Blockbuster, and that was more jarring than the post. Yeah, for someone who used to work in Blockbusters, I don't like the fact that it had to be explained to younger people what it could be. Dr. Mux also had a similar experience. When I was in high school, I was playing a board game in a public place with a couple of female friends of mine. Apparently, we were in the way of someone behind me. We were sitting on the ground. And apparently, my gorgeous flowing locks and dazzling feminine figure were enough to convince this person to say, "Excuse me, ladies." The look on her face was priceless. When I turned around to reveal my nasty peach fuzz stash and legally abortable goatee. I was embarrassed, but not much, because apparently, your boy is a very pretty lady. Another case of mistaken identity down in the comments. My ex and I were entering a crowded auditorium for a school performance. There were so many people squeezing through the double doors that she was afraid we'd get separated and not be able to sit together. So she reached behind to hold my hand. Instead of my hand, she found my crotch. So, thinking she'd have some fun, she gave my crotch a nice squeeze and, even better, started to fondle it, since no one could see anyway. Then, the crowd thinned out and she turned with a smile to see my reaction. Only, it wasn't me, it was some other guy. I was two steps behind. What has been your funniest fuck up? Let me know in the comments. Now back to r/drunk or a kid. So who was the person who ran into a brick wall? It was a kid. I was 6 years old playing tag with my friends, as kids do. I must have been too focused on the kid chasing me, or simply forgot I needed to turn, and ran headlong into a brick wall. It was a whole ordeal. Did you guess right? I knew this had to be a kid because I just don't think drunk people run that often. Thank you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed what you have heard, please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss anything from Emma Reed's Reddit. See you tomorrow!